Sejin here. In today's video, I'm going to show you an awesome pro tip on how you can get character consistency for a story with the very tool, also known as Inpainting on Midjourney. With a little time and creativity, you too can create your own style while keeping your character consistent. So if you like this sort of content, please make sure to like the video and subscribe to this channel. Let's dive right in. Okay, I'm going to jump right into the Niji server for Midjourney and test out three different settings for a prompt I have prepared for this tutorial. Here's the prompt. Cute bunny wearing a future mech, multiple poses, facial expressions, pastel color, plain background, aspect ratio 16 to 9. The pro tip here is to token multiple poses in the prompt in order to get different poses of the same character or object in one image. I'm going to prompt it with an expressive style. Now here's the default style. And a cute style. All the characters look very different due to the different style I use for each role. I want to use a character that stands out and has a bit more consistency. Make sure when choosing the character that the limbs are there and there's no awkwardness to it. I think I'll go with the fourth one from the default style. I'm going to generate a variation to see if I can get different versions in the same style. Okay, now we're getting somewhere. I like the different style of poses and I can definitely picture each of these characters in a different setting. For this tutorial, I'll keep it simple because I don't want to overcomplicate things. I'm going to upscale number 3 to access the vary tool and see if I can have each of the poses in a different scene. Okay, let's hit the vary tool. Now, this is where you have to pay attention. Three different poses for our mech rabbit character. I'm going to start with the first one. With the lasso tool, I'm going to draw around the rabbit as close to the character as possible. I'll start from the bottom right foot and carefully trace around the character. I found that getting it as close to the character as possible produces better blending of the character to their background. Be careful not to trace into their face since inpainting can mess up the face area. Now you see the checkered transparent box slowly covering the character. Now, once you're almost done tracing around the character, you'll want to trace away from the character and trace alongside the outer edge of the rectangular image box in order to inpaint around the character and not on the character. You'll see that as you go around, the rabbit will reappear and the area around it will be covered in the checker box where the inpainting will occur. You'll want to trace back to the part where you started, which in this case would be the bottom right foot. And we're done. We can prompt in whatever we want this character to be in. I'm going to change the prompt to, in a bustling futuristic city. Not too bad, the mech rabbit is actually quite big. I actually don't mind that, I think I'll go with number 4. Now let's go back to our original mech rabbit poses. Hit the reset button on the top left so we can trace around the middle mech rabbit. So the process is the same. Start at the bottom and slowly work your way around the character, and when you're close to the starting point, trace along the outer edge of the rectangular image box until you're back at square one. Let's change the prompt to walking through a city park. Hit enter. Okay, I like this one a lot. I definitely think I can see number 3 and 4 for my story. I'll probably flip one of the images to give it a different angle. Now since we have one more pose left, let's go around and use the same process to trace around the character. Let's change the prompt to looking at the city from afar. Okay, I'll go with number 4. Now with all the images generated with character consistencies, it's up to you to decide how you want to put your story together. If you want to use them for print, then click on the link that's popping up on top to learn how to upscale the image for print. Here's my final output using the 4 images that I picked for this tutorial. Let me know what you think in the comment box below. As always, thanks for watching to the very end, and if you enjoyed watching this video, consider giving it a like and subscribing to this channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.